In this video, we're doing a quick overview of all the vectors that are involved in a basic projectile motion without drag. So as we watch our projectile motion begin, we have our velocity vector shown in green, and that's always going to be tangential to the trajectory of the object. Our acceleration vector is shown in red, and that's the acceleration caused by gravity. That's a constant downward acceleration with a magnitude of g, or 9.8 meters per second squared. Now, as the motion continues, we see that the velocity vector always stays tangential to the trajectory, but it's rotating in order to do that, and the magnitude is decreasing. In other words, the speed is getting smaller. We can get a better understanding of this by putting the velocity components into the diagram. And we see the y velocity component is decreasing here because the y component points upward while the acceleration of gravity points downward. Now, because the y velocity is decreasing as we move upward, eventually we get to the point where the y velocity is zero. At this point, we're at the top of the trajectory, or the maximum height. That's the transition between positive y velocity and negative y velocity, so the y velocity must be zero at that point. Note that the x velocity never changes because there's no acceleration in the x direction, so the total velocity at the top of the trajectory is just equal to the initial x velocity, which never changes. So after we hit the top of the trajectory, that downward acceleration is going to keep adding in downward changes to the y velocity. And that means the y velocity now becomes negative. This negative y velocity component continues to grow on the way down, even as the x component of velocity stays constant. The velocity vector itself stays tangential to the trajectory, so that continues to rotate in order to stay tangential, and the length is now increasing due to the increasing length of the y component. In other words, the speed is increasing on the way down. Eventually, this thing is going to land, and we call the final velocity vector the impact velocity for the projectile. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.